Hello everyone, children. Today we are going to start with our new chapter. Okay, that is geometry, chapter number 14. So all of you can take out your book number 8, page number 2. So students, in this chapter we are going to learn basics of geometry. Okay, that is point, line segment, ray, lines, then type of lines, then 1 meter section, curved surface, plane surface, shapes. All these things we are going to discuss in this chapter. Okay, but before we start the chapter, we will do some revision. Okay, so I hope all of you have taken out your book, students. Okay, you can see here the first page is given some revision question. Okay, so here you have to answer right, true or false. Is it clear, students? So what it has to be done, that we will write T if it is true and for F if it is false. Okay. So, one number A, you can see your question is given a rectangle has 3 vertices. So, the answer is correct or wrong. It is true or false. Let us find it. So, you can see this is the picture of a rectangle. Okay, students. So, here I have mentioned the name, a point, corners name I have given A, B, C, D. Okay. So, in a rectangle, how many vertices are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. But what is vertices? Do you know, students, what is vertices? A point where 2 lines meet. Okay. Like you see here, BA and DA. Where they meet? At a point A. Isn't it? AB and BC. Where they meet? BC is the point. BC and CD. Where the point meet? C. CD and DA. The point will be C, D. Isn't it? So, these are the vertices. Okay. It is called vertices. So, how many vertices are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, in a rectangle, how many vertices there? 4 vertices. Okay. But here it is given 3. It means the answer will be false. So, we will write F. Number B, given a triangle has 3 vertices and 3 sides. Let us see. So, one side. This is the picture of a triangle. 2 side, 3 side. Isn't it? Now, here 1 vertex. Whenever it will be called one single, it will be called vertex. Okay. More than one, it will be called vertices. Okay, students. So, one vertex, two vertex, three vertex. So, overall, how many vertices are there? 3 vertices. Okay. It means this answer is correct. A triangle has 3 vertices and 3 sides. Okay. So, we'll write T. Number C, the number of vertices in a rectangle and a square are same. So, let us see. Rectangle, already we know that 4 vertices are there. And in a square, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Same, 4 vertices. It means the answer is correct. We will write T. Now, number D. The number of faces, edges and corners in a cuboid are 6, 8 and 12 respectively. Let us see. So, you can see this is the picture of a cuboid. Okay. So, here how many faces are there? Up, down. 2 faces, side, side. 2 faces means 2 plus 2, 4. And from back and front, 2. So, 2 plus 2 plus 2 is 6 faces. Okay. Let us find out how many edges are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So, how many edges are there? 12 edges. The lines, these lines are called edges. Okay. And how many corners are there? 1 corner, 2 corner, 3 corner, 4 corner, 5 corner, 6 corner, 7 corner, 8 corners. So, how many corners are there? 8 corners. So, it means this answer is correct. Okay? It is true. Number E, a cylinder has one circular and 2 curved faces. So, you can see here. This is the picture of a cylinder. So, how many curved faces are there? 1. Okay. How many curved faces are there? 1. And how many circular faces are there? How many circular is there? 1. And in down also 1 is there. That is 2. Okay. It means it has 2 circular and 1 curved faces. Isn't it? But here it is given 1 circular and 2 curved faces. It means the answer is wrong. We will write false. Is it clear, students? Now, come to question number 2. Question number 2 is given, observe the following pattern, draw the next on the patch. So this patterns you can see and you can solve this question on self. But I'm showing you a number. You can see circle, triangle, circle, triangle, circle. Then one triangle is drawn. Okay. So in this way you complete this question. Is it clear? I hope you have understood. Students, let us go to the next topic. So next topic is given basics of geometry. Okay. The first point is given as point only. Okay. The first topic is given as point. Now we will learn what is point. A fine dot. You can see the picture where dot is given. Made by a sharp pencil or by a pointed tip of a pen represents a point. Okay. It has an exact position or location. It has no length, breadth or thickness. We use a capital letter to name a point. Look at the points shown below. So a fine dot made by a sharp pencil. Okay, like here you see, here I have given one dot. So this dot is called a point. Okay, is it clear? So it has an exact position or location, but this point does not have length, breadth or thickness. Is it clear, students? And this can be use, and we can use a capital letter to name a point. Like you can see here picture, A point, Q point, B point, P point, R point, S point. So these names are given to this point. Is it clear? Now next line is given. So the above points are named as what point? A, B, R, Q, P, S. Okay, you can give any alphabet. Okay, you can give a name as any alphabet. Okay, students, clear? So this gone point. Now we will start the next topic, that is line segment. Let us mark two points X and Y on the paper. So on a paper, two points are marked, that is name is given X and Y. Now join the point X to Y with the help of a ruler to obtain a figure as shown below. Now with the help of a ruler, this point, both the points are joined from X to Y. Okay, so the straight path from X to Y is called the line segment XY. So after joining this, it is a straight path, isn't it? So this straight path is called line segment XY. What it is called? XY line segment. And it is written in this form. You see, student, this is the form it is written. Is it clear, students? At first two points are given, then after that with the help of a ruler this point are joined. Okay, after joining, so this straight path is called a line segment. Clear? And it is written in this form XY. The above you will draw the line segment. Next is given X and Y are called the end points of the line segment XY. So these two, and these are called the two end points. Okay, on measuring the distance between the point X and Y with the help of a ruler, we get the length of the segment XY. With the help of a ruler, I will show you how to measure it. Okay, students, you can see this is a ruler. Now let us measure it. Okay, here it is given. Here we will put one 0 point. Now we will measure. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and it is counted as 1, 2, 3. So the length of this length is 7.3 centimeters. Is it clear? So we have done this with the help of a ruler, isn't it? Now let us study the properties of a line segment. So what are the properties of a line segment, students? Let us see. It has two endpoints, which we have known that it has how many endpoints? Two endpoints. It has a definite length. It has a definite length. This line segment has a definite length. Like we have used the ruler and we have measured, and the answer has come 7.3. Number 3 point given, the length of a line segment can be measured with the help of a ruler, which I have shown you just now. And a line segment is a part of a line, and it is a part of a line. Is it clear, students? I hope it is clear to you. So students, in this video I have discussed about point and line segment. In the next video we will discuss the ray and lines. Okay, students, and I hope whatever I have taught you, you have understood. So all of you go through these topics. Is it clear? Okay, thank you.